Oh yeah, it's big.
Big fish.
But no matter what you've caught, or even what you've seen, there is always a bigger fish, a tougher fish.
Yeah, got it.
And it's out there. It's out there somewhere. Sharks, particularly big sharks, rate as one of the most feared creatures on the planet. But is it justified? Well, I don't think so. In fact, I think sharks have got more to worry about from humans than we do of them. Every year, millions of sharks are killed, and often it's only for their fins. So that's why we're out here to help with a research program where we're going to be taking DNA samples from sharks, putting tags in them, measuring them, and we're going to be doing this in New Zealand inshore waters. And by inshore waters, I mean inshore waters. If we hook up, we've got to try and get the shark back to this beach. Got him on. Big one on, boys.
Woo-hoo! Yeah!
There's his teeth too. Right by where my foot was. He's just dragging me round and round in circles. Oh! Oh! Oh!
In spring and summer, people head to the beach to swim, surf, and play. But it's also the time that sharks move into the shallows. And this is when humans and these large predators share the same piece of water. But it's not us that has to worry. As people populate more and more beaches, we need to know what effect we're having on the sharks' feeding and breeding. And to do this, we've been asked to collect three samples from these inshore waters in northern New Zealand. So first, I need to get my big bait out to the sharks. And the perfect way to do it is on my surfboard. And on the way out, I check in with my kids, Hannah and Shaw.
You guys seen any sharks?
No. Of course I haven't.
What's that on your board, Dad?
Shark baits, mate. Dad's gonna catch a sharky.
Awesome!
You guys wait here. Don't go out deep. Splash around lots to attract the shark for us.
The system here is pretty simple. I've got some chum and a big bait loaded up on the board, and I'm paddling it out. Well, back on the beach, my mates Josh and Kieran are feeding out the line.
Hooked up. Josh is clearing out the line. Go, go, go. Wine, 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 wine.
Go, go, go. Back up on it, bro.
We're backing down on this fish because he's taking a bit of line. He's obviously a very big shark. Oh, that is smoking some line. Then I've backed up about as far as I can back up. We've got to haul that fish on this big heavy tackle all the way back to the beach.
Into the shallows.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, this is what we come for. Okay, how's that, mate? You still tight?
Go, go, go! Back up on it, bro.
Go, go, go. Wine, 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 wine. At the moment, I'm just backing along the beach because the shark has gone on a fast run. It's only a couple of meters deep out there. Like, I mean, just beyond the line of where the surfers and swimmers are, and there's a very big shark racing along the beach. I might run forward on him, eh? Forward on him. Hey, Spud, sure, move the other way, please, bud. Good boy. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Let's go get him, boy! How you going, Kieran? You all right?
Yeah, sweet, bro.
Nice and tight.
Getting thirsty. It's just in the back of the
Hey,
waist.
Where are those kids of mine? Tell them to follow us. Gosh, Talk about multitasking. I've got to drive, back a trailer, watch an angler, and my kids at the same time. Tough job. And watch the camera operator. Look out, duck, line. The shark's right here. I'm going to have to, oh, up on the surface, splashing out there. Oh, yeah, mate. Come on, kids. Catch up. Catch up. We've got a big shark. Come on, guys.
Right on the surface. Look.
We're just going to have to go out and probably grab a hold of that shark because it looks like it's going to tangle in the weed because we've got to get that sample, that DNA sample.
That line's just full of weed.
Yeah. There he goes. Oh, look, go nuts. Okay, I was going to go clear some of this off the... Okay, kid. We're going to bring the shark up here, okay, guys? But you have to listen to Dad, okay?
Yeah.
If I say stand back, you have to stand back.
Yeah.
We've got a big shark! We've got a shark! With this line under so much load, if the weed weighs the line down, it could rub through the shells and it could snap off at any moment. We've really got to get a hold of that strong leader and get this fish right into the shallows. Just don't let him thrust towards you, mate. He's still got heaps to go because he hasn't really fought that much. Okay, I'm going to try and drag him, we'll grab him by the tail in a sec. Okay, just be careful, I don't want to turn it. Got bitten by a blooming paddle crab. Here I am with a big shark, and I've got a paddle crab biting at my feet. Okay. Okay, I've got to keep that line clear. He didn't like me touching his tail. He did not like me touching his tail.
Like, someone can hold this, I can grab by the crab.
So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.
Probably not a great time to be having a conference really, eh? We maybe should have thought of this. But I mean, we really had no time to think about this. I paddled the surfboard out there. Okay, this is the, Okay, just keep that camera rolling because it could get some cool stuff. If it bites one of us, it'll be great. Okay, just be careful if you're wrapping up, mate. He didn't like it when I touched his tail before, so he probably won't like it too much now either. Got a bit of weight there, so he can't turn on me, eh? Just want to get him shallow enough so we can get a good measure on him. Bring that tape measure too, Karen. Come and have a look, kids. Come here. We have to find out what sex it is. We've got to get a DNA, look out. We've got to get a DNA sample, and we've got to get it swimming back out there. Oh man, that is awesome. Just go back a little bit wider, mate. In that shot and come just up. Oh. Okay.
Nice fish, eh, mate?
Yeah, he's a nice one, boy. He's not a little one. Do you want to just watch that tail for a second for us, mate? Okay, now I've got a clean, sharp pair of scissors, and any little bit of fin on the fish will do. Okay, might thrash, be careful. Okay, that is all we need for a DNA sample. Okay, well our cameraman's going to put that under his wing or in his pocket. Okay, that's all good. Okay, tape measure, bro. Okay, I suppose you're going to stay at this end. Okay,
sweet.
Start with the long measure.
Yep.
Okay, this is where the pointy end. We've got to be just a wee bit careful. They've got a very sensitive nose, sharks. This is where all the electrosensory receptors are.
Sweet.
Okay.
2 meters, 930
miles. What was that? 29.
293.
293. Okay, sweet. That's almost a 3 meter shark. Well, we've just got to sex it, and then we can get it back out into the water. How I'm going to find out? Just easy. So raspy.
we have a look under here.
The male, oh, female, eh? There was no claspers.
Stick your hand in there.
Now, I wouldn't normally do this on the first date, but this is for science. No.
This is a female, it's a big female.
Hold that, it might not be very happy, guys, when the tag goes in, so. You guys want to come around and have a look at the shark?
Yeah!
Don't come, just be careful, okay, guys?
Okay.
We'll get a quick photo with Dave. Come here, come here. Okay. Okay, go now, guys. Okay, let's get this big girl back out so she can breathe. Okay, it's important to have the streamer going backwards. We're just going to pop it into this cartilage below the dorsal fin here. Okay, the tag's in it. But right now, we've got to get this very lively big shark back out deep enough water to carry on going about its business. Like to see a dorsal fin like this in a shallow beach, but believe me, they are here. They always have been. They've just got no beef with us. That is awesome. That is one big fish. We found at a local beach near you. Now there you go. A lot of people will be freaked out by that.
That was the first big shark that my kids have ever seen. And there they are, straight back in the water. So maybe you guys could take a lesson from these guys. Nothing to worry about.
Okay, guys, get out now. There's sharks out there. Guys, what about the shark? Let's go get him, boy!
We've successfully gathered a DNA sample, measured and tagged a large bronze whaler shark from the beach to help with research on the large sharks in our inshore waters. But today is the last day, and we still need to collect two more samples. So to find the sharks, we're stepping things up.
Today we're going to be fishing at one of New Zealand's most popular summer destinations. Popular for swimming, popular for surfing, but also popular for fishing. Now, we're going to be fishing here today on a beach that's going to be packed with holidaymakers in just a couple of weeks' time, and we're going to be fishing for sharks. The trouble is, there's an 18-kilometre stretch of beach here, and to find just one or two sharks that cruise along the coast here can be difficult. And that's why we've got this thing here. That there is a helicam, and these guys over here, Matt and Emerson, operating it. Now, the cool thing about this is Matt, he can fly the helicopter along the coast, and Emerson, with these cool goggles on here, can see exactly what the helicopter's seeing. Okay, you can just buzz that straight out over the water, Matt, and we can go and look for some sharks. Well, it looks extremely cool. It is not a gimmick. We are actually going to go out. The sharks are going to be cruising in this very shallow, clear water. So Matt's flying up and down the coast, and Emerson and I can see exactly what's going on.
Yeah. Oh, look, you can see in the water.
You can see in the water, all right. Mate, if there's a shark out there, we are going to see this puppy.
What is that over there?
Whereabouts? Oh, that, yeah, that, can you go?
Down that way.
Go down that way, it's moving too. It's moving out. Go to your right. Yeah, no, you're pan down, Emerson.
See those two dark shadows?
Yeah, can you go a little bit closer? Because they could be stingrays.
The downlink.
Those two there look like stingrays. But that one off to the right looks like a shark.
Oh, they're coming in this shot, the higher we go.
That was the one that was the shark.
Can you tilt your head back at all, Matt? You just...
Oh, sorry, I'm trying to look down.
Just
I can see, I can see the shark at the bottom of the shot. I'm trying to take a look
see
at it.
Oh, yep. There's two. See it?
Yep.
Big fin.
We need to move down the beach, and then about 300 or 400 meters out is where I'm going to have to take the baits. Okay, we know where the sharks are. Let's move on to phase two, which is going to be to catch one of said sharks. Yeah. The all-important surfboard wax. When you're on a surfboard with a shark, there's extra motivation not to slip off. That chopper is out of it, eh? Okay, guys, wish me luck. Well, the sharks that we spotted with the helicam seem to be about 400 meters out of the beach, so it's really quite simple. I paddle these baits, 400 metres out of shore and I drop them in the water. Although the sharks can be seen right in as shallow as you are there, Dave. Okay, if they see the sharks and I'll paddle right to the shark, I might even be able to drop it straight to them.
Hoping knows where to find the sharks, as we're going to run out of line soon.
Yeah.
There's one out to your right now. You're coming straight
out. The shark we spotted obviously wasn't interested in our bait. So now all we can do is wait for another one. But as we wait, we're burning up time, and we still need to get two more sharks to complete our research mission. And it's now come to the time we can't sit and wait anymore.
The shark research roadshow moves on, complete with vehicles, boats, surfboards, baits, and remote control helicopters. We're going to the other end of the beach. Well, this is our next idyllic little summer spot. Again, perfect for sunbathing, swimming, spending a good family time on the beach, and also an ideal spot for shark fishing. So a bit of blood, guts, bait, we'll same process, use a surfboard, paddle the baits out, and hopefully there'll be some sharks cruising this area. When doing this research, we've got to find sharks, so not to be alarmist, we've got to come to the same places that people swim and play. This looks beauty. Well, deploying the baits on the surfboard again. The only difference this time is I've got a bucket of chum. I'm going to take that out. When I deploy the baits, I'm also going to tip over the burley, which should attract the sharks to our bait. Good. There's a shark there. Okay, line, I'm going to have to go. See you later, bro. Grab the boat and come after me, okay? Uh-oh, got a bad rat then as well.
Oh, be careful, mate, he's getting aggro.
Okay, he's a bit grumpy now. Something just smashed the burley bomb. Josh, something just hit the balloon, bro. That was right on the balloon. Now, you see that, Blair? Oh, there's a big splash way out in the bay then too.
Out behind it?
Yeah, way out behind it. There it goes again. Yeah, we're bit. We're bit, guys. It must have broken off the balloon. That's probably what that splash was. Okay, whereabouts is that gimbal belt? Is it in the back of the truck? Now it's tightening up, it's going for it now. See that line ripping out there? Get that one in, bro. It might jump, that line's coming up. Right angle's coming up. It's taking line now, so we could get a jump, possibly. It's right up near the surface, I think, the fish. And it feels so bizarre to be harnessed up and with big game fishing tackle, standing on an idyllic holiday beach. Man, I'm not going to say which beach it is because the campground down the road is probably going to lose a bit of business, but seriously, you've got nothing to worry about these sharks.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Oh, it's smoking out. Ooh, there's a bit of loose line on there. Ooh. Bring around in. Don't touch that line, whatever you do. Bro, how long were we here? Like, how long was I? Whoa, mate, smoking out line, check that out. Mate, so it's not a little baby. I can tell you that much. I mean, how long was I back on the beach before that got bit?
2.5 minutes.
About 2 minutes. 2 minutes after I got back on the beach, after dropping burley off of the surfboard around the bait, yeah, literally, it's about 2 minutes. And look at that, we're hooked up.
Although, well, this is crystal clear water out here. I'm on a surfboard. I didn't see any sign of a shark. It just goes to show you, they know where you are. Just that they're shy of you. He waited till I was out of the way, and he come in and fed. I mean, really, if he thought I was food, he could have taken me out, but he didn't. It's because they don't. They're our mates. And that's why we've got to do this research to make sure they get to stay around for another few million or so years that they've evolved over. Damn, I wish I'd researched how many million years they've been around. I heard that on Discovery Channel once.
Is there someone to reel you?
Yeah, mate, that'd be good. I might actually need some more water to drink as well, bro. I'm gonna get toasted out here on the beach. Well, in the 10 minutes since I've been hooked up, yeah, bush telegraph's obviously been working because we had this beach to ourselves and a few spectators are starting to turn up. Okay, get that chopper up, bro. Just get the chopper up, the shark's just here. Should be able to see it in a sec. There he is, he's on the surface there, breaking the surface. Get it up there, boys. Shark's right there, see? It's a good one, man.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Goodie. He's right up on top, go, go. Watch that line, Blair, on your fins, bro. Straight just about 20 metres past Blair, the shark. See him? Just over there. He's swimming that way.
Back and turn left, spin left. Okay, hold. I'm right on them. He's swimming up to it.
Can you see it, bro?
Yeah.
Get down low to it, see if you can spook it. He's heading for those rocks. Can you see he's right in front of Blair, only a few metres away from Blair. Blair's almost touching the shark now.
Oh. Angry at him.
Mate, right in Blair's face. Oh, turn on Blair, don't get on that line, don't get wrapped up in that line, bro. He's just turned, he's gone back the other way. He's a little bit pissed. Oh, the awesomeness of this is too much to bear, look at that. Okay, he's coming up in the shallows here, guys. We might get a shot at him here. He's riding on the beach here, dudes. Get in and have a close look. Now you can see a lovely, happy holiday making family there. Mum, Dad and the kids, they're wondering what all this fuss is about. Well, little do they know it's a shark. Hey, I know you didn't sign up for this, but when we shout out for that tagger and that tape measure, you can run it down to us. You don't have to touch the shark, I promise. He's quite a dark one, eh? He's a nicey boy. Go in, get a shot, boys. The leader's right there if you want to walk out and slowly inch it over. Just watch him, he might bolt too, Karen. If he bolts, that line's going to run across you. Blair, our underwater cameraman, is right on the tail of the shark. Oh, man, that's awesome. Hey, bro, can I pass you this rod when I need to run out into the surf? No, no, you'll be all right, bro. Seriously. No, no. No, no, it's a Venezuela. Not as big as the one we got yesterday. But not bad. Okay, mate, if you just want to drop back, I'll call you forward if I need you. Sorry, what's your name?
Judd.
Judd, I'm Matt. Nice to meet you. Okay, who wants to grab this wire, man? We're all ready. It's go time, the wire's up. Okay, get ready to come, Judd. I'll pass you this rod, bro. Come here, bro. You got that wire? Here, mate, hold on to this for me.
Woohoo!
Just let it run if it wants to go, okay? He's got his head.
F***ing awesome. I shouldn't be swearing,
okay,
Kelly.
Just don't let that tip get wrapped, okay? And wind up any little bit. Just wind the handle slowly, mate, bit of slack. Don't try and stop anything with your hands. Okay, where's our tagger? You got his head there, bro? Tagger, please. Thank you. See Kiwis, eh, guys?
Yeah.
We're happy to help. I'll pass that back to you. Okay, mate, grab that in. Okay, we're experienced at this. We've done it once before. Yesterday. Okay, long measure is 2780. Yeah, 2780. The short is 2350. Sweet as, right fin clipping.
Yeah,
we'll
just use this
to cut it. Got it? Okay, there's our DNA sample. Don't lose that, that's important. Oh, I've got my release knot. Man, look at that. Oh, we've got a sextet, that's the other thing. I've got to find out what sextet is. You got his tail so he doesn't smash me?
Another female.
A female.
Oh, he's got someone else,
a
snapper hook.
Two snapper hooks
in
him,
mate.
Look at that. There you go.
Not
going
to get those
out. Yeah, be careful, mate. Yep. There's a hook, just be careful if he thrashes around.
Look. Long line hook there as well.
Someone's been out snapper fishing. Is it you guys? Okay, there's a shark here, okay. Well done, mate, see? We're helping our bro out with a couple of hooks from fishermen. Although they are recurve hooks, and for a shark this big, a hook in the corner of the mouth is like a small nose piercing for you or me. Not that I've ever had a nose piercing, but just an analogy I thought of while I was messing with a shark. Come around and get these teeth, bro.
Okay, just watch these teeth. I shouldn't be joking around in all seriousness. Now you see this recurve hook? It's worked exactly how we wanted it to.
It won't harm the fish.
Yeah, I know.
Watch him, mate. Push your toes. Okay, we've just got to steer this girl back out. Okay, chop her out and we'll send the shark towards you, okay, guys? Big, solid animals. Big, solid trucks. Okay. Away she goes. Okay, there it goes. It's under its own steam. Off to do its steam that sharks do. Not bad. She's already looking for what else she can eat. Think fish. They think fight or flight to survive. They think breed and they think look for food. And they'll be looking for food already. And there's some of its food right there. We've got a stingray. Quite ironic, one of the few times you'll see a stingray following a shark. Normally it's the other way around. What you'll probably find happening is that our shark friend is probably regurgitating some of his food, like emptying his stomach, and the stingray will be following him behind him, eating up all the scraps. Nothing gets wasted in the ocean. And here's our shark just over here, still cruising around on the bay.
That's our second shark released with a tag. So we need just one more DNA sample, and the mission is complete. So time to rig up again and do whatever it takes to get one more shark.
See you later, bro. Grab the boat and come after me, okay? Whoa, whoa, whoa! It's smoking! Okay. Away she goes. Off to do its thing that sharks do. Not bad.
We've just secured another DNA sample, measured and tagged our second shark from the beach. Now, we need just one more sample from a shark to complete our mission. So I'm paddling out another bait on my surfboard.
Okay, we've had another bite, although the trouble is we're starting to run out of line. We don't have as much line on the Stella. I'm gonna run out of line. I'm gonna have to go. See you later, bro. Grab the boat and come after me, okay? Holy smokes. See you later, dude. Go. It's smoking out line. Hey, the fish is straight up in front of me. Just go and tell these kayakers not to kayak over my line. We're hooked up to a shark.
That's nice, we're hooked up to a shark.
Hey, whoa. Stoking along, you're going to have to swim hard to try and keep up with me, man. Where's the heli coming too? Oh, man. Oh, I might jump out here. It's going nuts, bro. It's dragging me right over there to where all the swimmers are. Oh, man, this rod's just digging into my clingers. I think my clingers have got bigger because of this awesomeness. There's a helicopter, a remote control helicopter filming this. How sick is this? It's awesome. Okay, swimming over towards these rocks. And it's smoking off. And it's heading in towards those rocks, which I can't quite fathom at the moment. Drive up on it, you might get a look at the fish.
Mate, this is swimming right into the rocks. Come in a bit closer, fellas. This fish is, can't be far away. Okay, this shark has gone right into these rocks. I'm trying to get gloves on, but I don't want to bust off on it. There's my... Mate, it's right in the rocks. What's going on? Is this the world's smartest shark? He's gone right in these rocks here. What the heck's going on here? He's gone right up. He's almost going to, like, he's gone to beach himself. Okay, this fish hasn't really, after his big run to start with, hasn't really done much, so he's got plenty of grunt. Move up, move up, move up, move up, bro. Move up, move up. Don't be shy, man. The fish is close. He's right down there. I can see this. No, we're all right, we're all right. Let's be cool, man. Everyone's cool. We've only got a big shark on the line and we're on a surfboard. Nothing to worry about. Look at the shark. It's right down here. Oh, mate, the awesomeness of this is almost too much. Uh-oh, he's swimming around there. Uh-oh, he's coming back at me. Crap. Are you right? You're right? Whoa. Jeez, look at him go. Man, these things are known as tough, grunty, down, digging deep, tough fish, but they can put on a burst of speed like that, man. Oh, man. This whole operation of getting a DNA sample and tagging one of these sharks is obviously a whole lot easier off the beach. Off the surfboard, well, it might not be quite so easy. We might have to have a bit of a think about how we're going to do this, guys. Well, what we're going to do is want to get the shark up. Jeez, I'm shaking a bit. I'm not shaking because I'm scared. I'm shaking because there's a bit of adrenaline going. What we'll do is, well, I'll get the shark up. Actually, I don't know what we're going to do, really. Well, I guess we're just going to do our best, but the first thing I want to do is wear the shark out, mate, because it's still got heaps in it, eh, bro? Oh, jeez. Mate, see how we went into the rocks? Oh. Trying to get gloves on, trying to get cameras rolling. I'm trying to think about what the heck I'm going to do with this shark once it comes up to the surfboard. It's already showed me he ain't scared. In no time at all, this shark has towed me over a kilometre off of the beach, but it seems to be sticking to the shore because, I mean, this is home for these sharks. They live along the shoreline. And really, the weight of me and the surfboard combined for a creature this powerful really isn't putting up much resistance at all. This fish is just taking me for a sleigh ride and it's just going about its business. And that's the worrying thing. Because I'm not really making this fish work, when I get him up to the surfboard, he's gonna have plenty of grunt. He doesn't know our good intentions, that we're actually working for the survival of his entire species. In a roundabout sort of a way. Tell you what, that thing there, sharp, there, saw, might be calling me Matilda. Okay, as soon as I get him up, we're gonna want the tagger over pretty quick. Okay, that's as far as I'm gonna be able to wind, I think. Just gonna back that off. That's the leader. Okay, I've got the leader, heading back that other way. He's gonna pull me backwards, I think. Stay out of his way, bro. I've gone under the board. This could cause me a problem. Mate, this dude's just cruising around like, yeah, straight down here, there's a shark. Right there swimming at Blair at the moment. Oh, he's having a look at Blair. He's right on Blair. In fact, he's, oh, I know, I can't really do much about it because I've clipped the rod on. He's in front of me. Okay, he's just doing laps around us. See, he's king of this domain. He's got no reason to fear us. The hook's not hurting him. He's just checking us out, which is the worrying thing right now that I'm on a surfboard and this is going down. What do you reckon? This is not at all what I expected. I think because there's no resistance on the surfboard, he's got no reason to panic. He's just like, what are these goofballs doing following me around? What's this clown on the surfboard doing? I'm asking myself what the clown on the surfboard's doing as well right now. Just watch, he's irking. I can't even see him now. What's that? Blair just asked me, is it bad that the shark's circling us? I don't really know, but it's probably not a good thing. Mate, are you quite happy to still be in the water, bro? You alright? Because this shark is pretty grumpy. Which way's he gone? Okay, look, this shark is just dragging me round and round in circles. He's just cruising around, trying to figure out what's going on. And it's a little bit disconcerting that I've got this fish on the line and I'm on a surfboard and he's kind of circling me. And it's making it really awkward to sort of grab the leader as well. He's just spinning this board around at will. Okay, I'm grabbing that leader. I've got a wrap. I don't have proper wiring gloves either, so
and I don't want to pull the board over. Like, this shark is well capable of pulling this surfboard right under the water and me with it. So I've just got to try and keep my balance. Oh man, this is not ideal. Man, I've just got to concentrate on what I'm doing. My feet dangling in the water. Okay, he's going to feel this resistance soon and he might just arc up. Here he is right here. I don't want those teeth pointing at me. That's around the rod. He's a bit of a grumpy one. He's under my left foot. Okay, thank you. Bring up left foot. Every time I pull on the leader, of course, I'm pointing the dangerous end at me. Maybe someone throw me the tagger now, eh? At least I'll get a tag in him if I can't get a sample. It's coming to the stage we've got to do something. But maybe Blair can swim it over. Go and grab us the tagger, please, bro. Oh, there he is. Okay. I would get Blair to tag him underwater, but then we might miss some footage. And oh, his tail hit my foot. Yeah, pass that tagger, bro. Pass that tagger. Oh, oh, come on.
We're helping out a study that is researching the big sharks that share the shallow inshore waters with humans. And we have to measure, tag, and release three sharks to get a decent data sample.
293. Okay, sweet, that's almost a 3 meter shark.
But more importantly, we also need to get a DNA sample from these sharks that live at this popular beach where holidaymakers come to swim, surf, and play. And in fact, we found that a surfboard is the perfect way to get our bait out. So far, we've caught two sharks that we've wrestled up onto the beach to get the DNA sample and data we need.
Sweet as, right fin clipping. Good.
And with just hours remaining on our trip, we've hooked the third shark that we need. But the reel has run out of line and I've been forced onto the surfboard and been dragged away from the beach.
See you later, bro. Grab the boat and come after me, okay?
Which has just made the task much harder.
What we'll do is, well, I'll get the shark up. Actually, I don't know what we're going to do, really.
So with my team and camera crew in tow, I've got to try and get the job done. Whoa. From the surfboard.
Look at him go.
But if you think that's tough, spare a thought for Blair, our underwater cameraman.
Just want to watch that rod tip too. So if that goes... I don't want to get tangled in that line. I do not want to get tangled in that line. This is pretty anxious sort of stuff. Oh.
Get him off the line.
Go. You're still on the boat. Go. Oh, you're clear. You go back as well, guys. Okay. Oops, the daisies. Lucky I clipped the rod on, because that was coming out of the rod holder then. See if I can get that leader back, eh? Mate, this is not ideal. Blair, if you could let go so I can spin around. Yeah. I can't even believe you understood me then. He's heading back to the bloody beach. He's heading back for the beach. Okay, he's at the rod tip again. Crap, he's coming straight at, he's not even pulling, mate. He's coming straight at the board all the time. Oh, man. He's just really green, yeah. Come out. Okay, well, mate, there's a shark right under the board, man. He's just turned, okay, I might get a shot at him here. He always, look out, Blair. Jeez, I pulled his head back from Blair. Okay, I might get a tag shot here. He's not gonna like it. Oh, jeez, I can't quite see him. I don't wanna tag him somewhere where it might hurt him, you see? Ah, oh, far out. Jeez, that rod almost came out again. Uh-oh. Okay, got the tag in, the tag's in him. Got the tag in him here, catch this, bro. Catch this, just come back. Come back. It's on the anchor. Oh, jeez. Push it down. Crisis averted, it's okay. We're just shark fishing from the surfboard. Everything's fine. Somehow I don't think shark surfing's gonna catch on and be the latest craze this summer. Can you guys sense the ridiculousness of what's happening right now? I think we all can. We've just had the most awesome couple of days tagging sharks for research off the beach, getting up close to these amazing animals and doing some really valuable work at the same time. I mean, as far as work goes, could it get any better? But at the moment, there's a sense of, is this happening right now? That's the way I feel anyway. There's a shark on here.
It's a nice way to spend a Sunday afternoon.
Okay, he's just trucking along, he's heading out. He's actually swimming a little bit harder now. Okay, I've got to, it's just, when he's down on a steep angle like this, he's really putting a lot of leverage on and pulling the board over. Of course, it wouldn't be very good. Okay, maybe get my release off in my mouth. Gonna make sure that this line doesn't get wrapped around me.
Be careful, mate, he's getting aggro.
Okay. Yeah, I know, mate. Don't want to get too much fin. There's his teeth too, right by where my foot was. Maybe a little bit of that fin. Missed. He's not gonna last like this very long. Uh-oh. Got a bad rap then as well. That was close. Okay, he's a bit grumpy now. Man, far out. I don't want to chew on my blooming feet either. Get that over his fin. Yep, I got it, boys. Oh. Oh, I got the sample. I got the sample of his fin in my release knife. Now we just got to shorten them up and cut them off right close to the line, but I don't want to lose the sample at the same time. There's only a tiny little bit of fin in there, but it's enough. We've got the crucial part there, which is the DNA sample, which is going to enable us to be able to track the movements and the migratory patterns of these fish. Now I've got another clean release knife that I can just shorten them right up and cut that line right close to his mouth. I hate it when I can't see him. He's wrapped up. Oh, I've got him unwrapped now. Okay, now his teeth are pointing straight at me, which I don't like, because those teeth are very sharp. Okay, he's got an eye on, a bead on me. Sorry, mate, about the inconvenience. Oh, shit. Oh, okay, away you go. I've got 10 fingers and 10 toes. And we got our sample. That's crazy, away he goes. So there you go. If that is not a graphic illustration of just how close big sharks are to people, nothing is, but really, you've got nothing to worry about. Hopefully the sharks don't have too much more to worry about. As we learn that they are coming regularly into these inshore waters to breed, these beautiful apex ocean predators will be around for a lot longer to come. If you've enjoyed this episode of Ultimate Fishing with Matt Watson, chances are you're going to want to see some more. Well, we've got you covered at ultimatefishing.tv, where we've got fishing action filmed from all around the world, big boats, small boats, all kinds of tackle and fish, advertising free. It's all covered at ultimatefishing.tv, or you can download the free Ultimate Fishing app.